Live from Kemper Arena in Kansas City, Missouri, it's International Hockey League playoff action with the Salt Lake Golden Eagles and the Western Division champion Kansas City Blades. Good evening, everybody. I'm Mike Varick, and welcome to Kemper Arena. Tonight, the Salt Lake Golden Eagles take on Kansas City in Game 2 of their best-of-7 playoff series. Last night here at Kemper, the Golden Eagles dropped Game 1, and it was a Jeff Medill power play goal late in the second period to give the Blades the lead at 2-1. They scored three more in the third period, en route to a 5-3 victory, opening up a one-game-to-nothing lead over Salt Lake in the best-of-7 playoff series. Joining me in the broadcast tonight is a gentleman that played on a Stanley Cup championship team with the Montreal Canadiens, Randy Busick. Alongside Randy, the Eagles find themselves down 1-0.
1-0, Mike, but that's only the first game. They gave up a goal at the end of the second and at the start of the third. If they can plug up leaks like that, they should fare very well tonight.
Well, tonight the Eagles will try and pound home goals against a world-class goaltender. He played for the Soviet national team, Artur Irbay.
Well, what can you say about this guy, Mike? He was the only goaltender in the league to have an under 3 goals against average at 2.46. He comes in with a 91% save average. Hey, he's one of the best goalies in the league, and he's very, very tough to beat.
Offensively for Salt Lake, the Eagles will rely on Rich Chernomaz. The Eagles captain most recently set a franchise record for most goals in an Eagles uniform.
Well, Rich Chernomaz brings in to the lineup intensity and a lot of playoff experience. He's one of two remaining members of the Golden Eagles that were with the 1987-88 Turner Cup championship team.
Well, the Eagles will have to pepper, as mentioned, the goaltender Artur Irbay, and one of the keys on our Franklin game plan is going to be the shots on goal.
Well, last night the Golden Eagles were outshot 35-19. Mike, they really have to tighten that gap up. Bobby Francis would like to keep Kansas City to a maximum of 25 shots and have his Golden Eagles pepper Irbay with at least 25.
And for the Golden Eagles, offensively, they're going to have to score on the power play, and the special teams in playoffs, always very important.
Well, special teams come postseason play, Mike, can make or break you. It's very important for the Golden Eagles to score a couple of power play goals and definitely not let Kansas City get on the board when they get the chances.
Last night, 7 power play chances for Kansas City. They scored once on the power play. The Golden Eagles have been in postseason play for 19 years. Continued excellence in Salt Lake City, and they'll try and continue that here tonight against Kansas City. We'll have all the play-by-play game 2, the Eagles and the Blades, in just a moment. Welcome to Salt Lake Golden Eagles hockey, and you hear our national anthem from Kemper Arena. I'm Mike Varick, alongside Randy Busick. Game 2 of the best-of-7 Turner Cup playoff series. The Blades lead 1-0. As you have a chance to watch the broadcast tonight, don't forget you can order your tickets for Game A, which will be April 14th, or Game B, April 16th, during this broadcast, and receive a $2 discount on all seats. Call 532-GOLD now. Operators are standing by. That's 532-GOLD, good only during tonight's broadcast. Well, it's the Salt Lake Golden Eagles in Kansas City. Tonight's starting goaltender is the starting lineup's brought to you by Blue Cross and Blue Shield. For 50 years, Blue Cross and Blue Shield, Utah's favorite color of insurance. Scott Sharples in goal for Salt Lake, 9-18-4 in 35 games this year. Kevin Dahl and Kevin Melrose on defense, the forward line. Dennis Holland flanked by Rich Chernomaz and Kerry Clark. Artur Irbay, 24-7-1 for Kansas City. Sandis Olsenich and Claudio Scrimmon on defense. John Carter, Michael Kravitz, and Kevin Evans up front. And we're underway here in Kemper. And the playback of the Salt Lake goal, and the Eagles gain possession on the left wing side. On the far wing now, Salt Lake's Rich Chernomaz. Headmans for Dennis Holland into the neutral zone. Skated off at center, and the 19-year-old Olsenich on the right side. Plays for Michael Kravitz, who dumps it right back of the Salt Lake goal, and the Eagles gain possession. Just underway here in Kansas City, Missouri, and Rich Chernomaz on his way into the Blade zone, skated off hard at the defense in the playback of the goal, and the Blades gain possession. Kansas City took the opener last night, and Thomas Forslund, the Swedish native for Salt Lake, clears into the corner, and Kansas City played up the middle for a streaking John Carter out of his reach, and Kevin Guy back after it. He played on a Turner Cup championship with Salt Lake in 1987-88 for Thomas Forslund. At center ice for Sean Afey, the puck rolls on edge and cleared right back in by Forslund deep into the Kansas City zone. And Dean Kolstad, the former Minnesota North Star, at center ice for their leading scorer this year. Gary Emmons down the right side. He shoots. Hit wide of the target. And it caroms wide on the far wing and up to center ice. The best scoring chance early for Kansas City. And the Blades clear it right back in. The Blades outshot the Eagles last evening 35-19. And that was a key difference in the game with the Blades outscoring Salt Lake 5-3. There's Sean Afey at center, skated off into the neutral zone, and the Blades back after to their own defense. Here's Jeff Medill into the center ice area, skated off in Salt Lake control. Paul Cruz down the left wing side, shoots off his stick and up into the stands. It deflected and caroms onto the far corner with 18-18 left in the first period. Just underway, we have no score. And Arthur Irbe in goal tonight for Kansas City. He was the Norris Trophy winner along with Wade Flaherty, the top two netminders in the IHL, and he was obviously a tremendous goaltender this year with a 91% save percentage.
Absolutely phenomenal, Mike, and you know, it makes it tough because Kansas City has such a great defensive team, and then when you finally get by the defense, you have to try and go against Irbe, and this guy's just been flawless all season long.
Well, there you see on the far side, back behind the goal, actually an actual open spot underneath the boards, Randy. We actually saw a puck go through there last night.
Well, not very often you see something like that happen, a rarity in hockey, but cause a little bit of problems, and we'll watch for that. It could be a key difference, because when that puck goes around the boards, could take some funny hops, and the goaltender could get in trouble.
And there's Irbe losing possession, chance in front, and tipped away. And there was a good scoring chance for Salt Lake as the puck rolls to center, and Darren Stolk, who played 23 games with the Blades last year, chops it for Todd Harkins at center, and it deflects right to deep into the Blades zone. Irbe plays it on the right side, and Ed Courtney leads it free to center ice. Here is JF Quintin to the flip it right back in. Several members of these Blades played last year in Kalamazoo, a Minnesota North Stars affiliate, and we'll touch on that as the night progresses. Here's Dwayne Joyce trying to center one, but tipped away to the far side, and here's Brian Diesel, a for Salt Lake. The forward on the far wing to tie it up into the center ice area, and Kevin Dahl twirls back for the Eagles. No score. 2:36 gone to the first period, and the Eagles gain possession. Up the middle, it's C.J. Young plays it free, and Dwayne Joyce able to pop it right back into the Salt Lake end. It was a scoreless game through the second period last night before the Blades scored the first one at the point. Oh, and it shoots, and Scott Sharples gets a piece of that. Here's the play in front. John Carter in our goal. His shot, an escape save by Sharples. Playing to the far side, and here come the Golden Eagles. Rich Turnaman's able to burst to center ice. Had 20 goals during the regular year. On the right side for Kevin Dahl. Trying to center one does. C.J. Young a chance. Irbe gets a piece of that, and the Blades break free to center on a 2-on-2. Carter into the Salt Lake zone. Trying to squeeze past, but poked away on left wing, and Sharples clears it into the stands, but he's going to get called for a penalty as Derek Martin going to call our first one to delay of the game. No score here at Kemper Arena between the Eagles and the Blades. We'll come back with more play-by-play in just a moment. Mike Barrack alongside Randy Busick here at Kemper Arena. Scott Sharples, a delay of the game minor at 3:20, and the Blades will go on the power play. Kansas City during the regular season ranked second in the IHL in power plays with 85 men advantage goals and a 22% mark, just under 22%. Here's the play on left wing. Jeff Medill in front for Larry DePalma on goal. Shoots! He scores! Well, it's a power play goal. Larry DePalma, who scored the first one last night, does it again. A 1-0 Kansas City lead.
Well, he gets the team going, Mike. Here comes DePalma. Nobody picks him up. He's all alone against Sharples, and he throws one in between the legs as Sharples tried to block the far side. DePalma saw an opening between the legs and throws it between. Here it comes. Both defensemen got caught in the far side, leaving DePalma wide open, and he makes no mistake when he comes in one-on-one against Sharples.
Larry DePalma, during the regular year for the Kansas City Blades, at 28 goals. He's a big, rough, tough forward, but he also has some finesse and was able to score the goal for the Blades.
Well, probably not known as a goal scorer, Mike, but boy, the last couple of games he's been a factor. He's got his team going early in both games.
Okay, Dwayne Joyce and Dean Kolstad on the assists. DePalma's second goal of postseason. Time of the goal, 3:44, and a 1-0 Blades lead, but Kevin Werben back the other way. His shot blocked away. Now Harkins for Salt Lake, able to cue it right back of the goal, and Irbe himself trying to set it free. Here's Deasley for Salt Lake, trying to yank it free to the corner. Eagles, Paul Cruz trying to jostle it free as the forward line. Harkins, Cruz, and Deasley. Here's Harkins cuts in, trying to center one for Cruz, into Harkins. Now Cruz again, centers one. Tipped away on left wing and cleared, but not out. Wortman holds it in. Wortman won the Ken McKenzie Award for IHL's Best rookie. Here's the play on right wing. Best American-born rookie, I should say. Here's Joyce, right side for Courtney. Trying to center one. Poked away to the corner, and then the puck cleared back of the goal. Played trying to center one. But Kellen Wartman able to leave it free on left wing, and Harkins able to bang it to center. And Claudio Scrimmon able to scoop it right back in. 4:50 gone. First period, the Blades have jumped to an early 1-0 lead. And Darren Stoke, who had 2 goals during the season for Salt Lake, able to play it free. Former Boston Bruin John Carter skated off by Chernomaz. They fight for it ferociously along the boards. The Eagles trying to push it free. Carter tries to freeze along the boards, and finally they succeed on the far wing. With 5:08 gone, first period, the Blades have outshot Salt Lake early 3-0 and have a 1-0 lead. John Carter, the most playoff experience for Kansas City, played for the Boston Bruins. And a look at Bob Francis, his third year behind the bench for the Salt Lake hockey team. His three-year record, 120, 104, and 23. A tremendous mark behind the bench.
Well, he knows being down 1-0 in a series, Mike, doesn't really mean a lot at this point in time. But they definitely want to come out with a victory tonight, have a split in Kansas City, and head back to Salt Lake in good standings.
Here are the Eagles clearing it in, but Irbe himself pops to center, and Solix Holland winds it in offside with 5:17 gone into the first 1-0 Blades. Tonight's referee is Derek Martin, the linesmen are Jerry Burt and Jeff Gardner. Eagles have 4 players scratch tonight. Kevin Grant is back in Salt Lake City with a knee injury. Richard Zemlak, Darren Banks, and Todd Strube all out tonight for the Salt Lake Golden Eagles.
Well, I'll tell you, Mike, they've had some problems. Shots on net already. Kansas City 3-0. The Eagles have to get that puck deep and sustain a forecheck, tire out the defense of the Kansas City Blades, and hopefully do some cycling and get some shots against Irby.
Eagles gain possession back of the goal, and Kevin Melrose, who was on an NCAA championship team at Harvard, holds on back of his net. Eagles gain possession, and Melrose able to pop it to center, but John Carter able to whip it right back in, and it's offside at the defense with 5:37 gone into the opening period. Don't forget the Fanatical Fan Contest, sponsored by Delta Airlines, and that will be ongoing during postseason play. It will be sponsored by Delta Airlines. It will take place every playoff home game. Dress up, paint your face, make a sign, get wild, do whatever it takes. During the Eagles game, the Eagles will choose the Fanatic Fan of the Night, and that person will win a trip for two on Delta Airlines, anywhere Delta flies in the continental United States. Here's the play back of the goal in the Salt Lake zone, and Darryl Olsen gains possession on the right wing side, able to poke it free to the blue line. Dean Kolstad trying to hold it in. His shot and steered aside by Sharples. And Salt Lake Sean Afey zigzags to center, able to cross the red line into the Kansas City zone, and he pokes it free. And back after this, Tom Peterson, who played much of the year with the U.S. national team in Kansas City with a tremendous record when they score the first goal during the regular season, and the Eagles knock it in high, and it looks like a holding call on the far wing, and we'll have our first penalty of the night as Derek Martin skates to the near side. 13:51 to go in the first period. 1-0 Blades. Eagles appear to be a man short, and we'll come back with a play-by-play in just a moment. Mike Barrick alongside Randy Busick, and a look at the Tim Harris penalty.
Well, Harris just hauls down Peterson, and it didn't take too long for Martin to blow that one down. The Eagles are shorthanded again. They haven't been able to get a shot on goal yet, so it's hard for them to go into a shorthanded situation.
Kansas City, second best in the league in power plays this year. Harris for holding at 6:09. Here's a chance for the Blades as they try and center one out of the point. Quick shot, Sharples a save, rebound Emmons. Holding on, being watched by Darryl Olsen. At the left wing point, Dwayne Joyce, hands for Emmons. Scores! Wow, you can't give the Blades a power play. They've scored twice on man advantage goals, and the most dangerous of them all. It is the forward Gary Emmons scores for Kansas City.
Well, Gary Emmons walks in on the top of the picture. No one touches him. He has an open lane. And anytime you're firing from the top of the circles or inside, that's a great area. He's right at the dot. He lets one fly. He beats Sharples high over top of the blocker glove.
Gary Emmons for the Blades, his first playoff goal, and another power play marker for Kansas City. Not much Sharples could do.
Well, not much, Mike. That was a great shot by Emmons high over top, but the Golden Eagles penalty killing unit has to keep them a little further out. They let Emmons get inside that little square that they're trying to hold him to, and Emmons was able to get into the top of the circles and just let a blast go.
Gary Emmons has been picked three times by different National Hockey League teams in the supplemental draft as a free agent and finally signed by Minnesota and eventually picked up by Kansas City and signed as a free agent this summer. And the Blades have a 2-0 lead. Here's Kevin Melrose back the other way for Salt Lake. Stick handles it on goal. A weak backhander and steered aside. Eagles have still not registered a shot on goal. And it's played to the right point, and Kevin Dahl at center ice able to wind it right back into Kansas City territory. 12:50 to go, first period. Two-man advantage tallies the difference in the Blades of a 2-0 lead, and there's that puck going underneath that area behind the Kansas City goal. Order your tickets for game A, April 14th, or game B, April 16th during this broadcast, and receive a $2 discount on all seats. Call 532-GOLD now. Operators are standing by. That's 532-GOLD, but only during tonight's broadcast. And Randy, Tuesday night, a chance in game number 3 at the Delta Center to see the Eagles against this very, very strong Kansas City team.
Well, it should be another great game, Mike, but I'll tell you, the Golden Eagles, the way things are set up, really not in that bad of a situation because they have three games at home before they have to come back to Kemper Arena, so they really have a great chance on home ice, having that home ice advantage to do really well in this series.
Here's the play on the right side of the Blades, now played on the opposite wing. In his center ice, and here is the chance for Kevin Evans, and on goal, rolls away. He get away from Harkins and flings it into the corner, but Salt Lake's Cruz gained possession. And then he's able to yank it free on left wing for Harkins, who dumps into the neutral zone, but breaking it up is Scremin in his center ice. Blades do a great job of sending three men back into the center ice area. Eagles are going to have to dump and chase. Here's Stolko on left wing, trying to hold on, plays it for Deasley. Wound out back of the net, but we're going to have a stop to play to the right of Archer Earbank.
Well, Mike, I think one of the Kansas City Blades went down. Brian Deasley got a stick up high when he was trying to knock that puck deep into the corner. It was an accident. I don't believe that Derek Martin's going to call a penalty, but here as Deasley tries to throw it deep, he gets a stick up high, and he catches Mikael Kravitz right in the face.
And the Eagles had a situation last night in which a stick was high, Kerry Clark, and he picked up a game misconduct.
Well, there you see the Kansas City team arguing with the referee, Derek Martin, saying, hey, it doesn't matter if it was an accident or not. The player's responsible for a stick, and it's a penalty. But Derek Martin didn't see it that way, and that's a good thing for the Golden Eagles that they won't be in a shorthanded situation.
Eagles, during the regular season, Randy, gave up 483 man advantage chances. They gave up also 98 power play goals, and as Bob Francis has said, they have to stay out of that box. It's hurt them all year long.
Well, it's been a problem all year, Mike. They have to have discipline, especially with a team like Kansas City, who is the second best in the power play scoring. But Mikael Kravitz, he had a great season. He's not a big goal scorer, but a great defensive player.
One of three players on Kansas City who hails from the Soviet Union. He played in the Soviet League. So did Sandis Ozolinch and the goaltender Archer Earbank. Here's the play on right wing, and the Blades trying to float it free into center. And here is the centerman, John Carter, on left wing. Poke check, and the Eagles wind it right back in. It is Hanfi Young and Forslund up front. Here's the play on left wing, and Carter maintains possession for Kansas City. The former Boston Bruin in across the line. Works against Guy, knocked out, and Derek Martin lets it go. The fans look for a penalty. They're all over the Chicago native, Derek Martin. On left wing, it is Darryl Olsen in center. Stick handles on left wing for Young and on goal, but it's offside as Young just one stride ahead of the play. Offside, 8:18 gone into the first period. Bob Francis a little bit frustrated. We talked about the penalties, Randy. The first one was a strange one as Scott Sharp was just barely cleared the puck over the glass, and it wasn't one of those penalties that should hurt you. But here's a play as Young was just ahead of the play offside into the Blade zone.
Well, foot offside, Mike, but 11:42 left to go in this period, and the Eagles have yet to register a shot on net. I'm sure that this is going to be a concern of Bobby Francis. He definitely wanted to get a lot of chances against Airbnb, and they haven't been able to do that yet.
6-0, the shots on goal. Here's Melrose, a shot in front, rebound, and it's cleared away, and the Eagles getting their first shot at almost another one, as I believe Dwayne Joyce was able to block the second chance. Irby makes the first save, and he was helped out by his defenseman on the second opportunity.
Well, that was the best, the only scoring opportunity the Eagles have had. A great tip here in front, and that makes it very difficult for the goaltender to stop, but you can see the Eagles crashing the net, getting control of that rebound, and trying to force another shot against Irby, but the puck skitters up into Dwayne Joyce's jersey and causes a stoppage of play.
Faced off deep into the Kansas City zone, 11:29 left in the opening period, 2-0 Blades. And we're excited to have this playoff battle back in Salt Lake City for you as we have a playback of the Golden Eagles player upended, I believe. And nope, it's going to go against Salt Lake. Another penalty against the Eagles. Back of the Kansas City goal.
Well, here comes the captain, Rich Chernomaz. He's going into the corner hard with Peterson. Throws him up against the glass and then throws him down to the ice. Derek Martin's not going to let this one go by, Mike. He's going to blow a two-minute minor. And again, the Golden Eagles are going to go into a shorthanded situation with not quite half this period gone.
8 minutes and 39 seconds gone to be exact, and the Eagles will have to face another Kansas City power play here. We've not even seen Peter Lappin much in the power play. He's their leading power play goal scorer with 17. He played with Salt Lake on a Turner Cup championship team. It's a roughing call, 8:39 the time in Kansas City on their third power play as Kevin Constantine, the Blades head coach, I'm sure very pleased about the way things have gone so far.
Well, he's got to be happy, Mike, and he'll be even more elated if Kansas City is able to put one by here on the power play.
They are two for two so far. It is Salt Lake Sean Hafey and Tim Harris up front to kill it off. Kevin Dahl and Kevin Melrose on the back line. And the Golden Eagles have given up 98 power play goals. Here's a quick shot towards the net, and Scott Sharples able to pounce on top. And hold on, Scott Sharples playing 35 games this year. He played 20 in the first half, and in the second half of the year played 15, and he was able to pounce on top of that loose puck into the Salt Lake zone.
And here you see the Kansas City Blades coming in, having another 3-on-2 opportunity, but DePalma was right there looking for a rebound. Scott Sharples does a great job of holding on to it and getting a face-off.
Bob Francis said he wanted Sharples to start tonight based on his record against the Blades, over 500 during the 1991-92 season. Eagles immediately clear it to center, and Dwayne Joyce has to spin back for the Blades. And he slowly holds on back of his net. Kansas City leading 2-0, having their third power play working out of there on the left wing side. It is cleared by Joyce deep into the Salt Lake zone. It rims along the board. Salt Lake's Harris turns, shoots it outside the blue line and in the center. Then Dwayne Joyce pops it right back on right wing for Kolstad. Headman's in for Medill, in across the line, rakes it up and then feeds for the forward Emmett. He circles back to the point for Joyce, to Emmons, closing in, back to the point for Joyce, shoots, and a stick save by Sharples, and then cleared by Hafey, I should say, all the way down, deep into the Blade zone. Crazily bounces off the backboards in front, and Irbe leaves it there on the left wing shot, and it's back of the goal, so the Eagles have killed off over a minute into this power play so far, and the Blades work out of it. Here's the former Maine Black Bears scramming on left wing for Tom Peterson. Pulls up, able to play it free on the far side, and the dangerous Peterson is scrambling at the right point. Peterson shoots, and that caroms wide of the target, and the Eagles clear it to the blue line. Scrimmin, able to hold it in. Michael Kravitz now for the Blades. Back to the point for Scrimmin, to Kravitz now. Poke check, Carter centers, and Fusty scores! Just 15 seconds left of the Chernomaz penalty. Michael Kravitz bangs it home, a power play goal and a 3-0.
Well, a little bit of give and go here. Carter into Kravitz, who is crashing the net. He gets the one-timer against Sharples. There goes, the puck goes down low to Carter. He finds Kravitz streaking towards the net, throws it right back to him. Kravitz one-times it right between the pads of Scott Sharples.
Wow, and all three man advantage goals, Randy, and that's got to be the most disheartening aspect so far.
Well, we talked about the special teams at the start of this game, Mike, how important they were going to be. And last night, the Golden Eagles gave up 7 power play opportunities. They were only, they killed off 6 of them, but tonight they haven't been as fortunate.
Here's a play now back of the goal. Eagles now down 3-0, and they're going to need something to give them some spark. Here's the play in front, but the Blades at Courtney able to wind it to center. The Blades at 116 points during the regular season. They were the Huber champions for the overall best record of the league. And you can see why based on this first period. Here's the play on right wing, and it is cleared by Keen Chen deep into the Salt Lake zone, and Sharples himself winds it free on left wing. Kravitz from Kevin Evans. John Carter also got an assist on that goal. And the Eagles clear it right back deep behind the goal. And Irbe himself sets it up for his own defense. And Kansas City scrimming slowly maneuvers out of there into the neutral zone. Clearing it right back deep into the Salt Lake territory. Draw back after icing is the call. With 8:36 to go in the first, the Blades have jumped to a 3-0 lead. And we'll come back with more from Kemp Arena in just a moment. Face-off deep into the Blade zone. Kansas City out shooting Salt Lake, Randy. 8-1 in the first period and jumping to a 3-0 lead.
Well, the power play has been the whole story so far tonight, Mike. Kansas City doing a great job getting all the shots on net. Irby has only been tested once on one shot. As we said, the power plays a difference right now.
Dennis Holland, Kerry Clark, and Rich Chernomas is the forward line. They've been together for the last two or three weeks as Peter Lappin able to wind it free to center, and Larry DePalma able to hold on at center. Here is the forward DePalma in across the line and shoots, and that caroms off the backboards and wide. Eagles clear it on left wing, and here's Kerry Clark. Winds, but not out. Peterson has shot. Caroms high in the air, and Rich Chernomas paws it down to Kevin Dawn. You can do that in your own end. You can use your hand to pass the puck. Here's the play at center ice, and Gary Emmett's on left wing to Palma. Wines shoots in a pad save by Scott Sharples. And the play loose on left wing, and Chernomas able to gain possession. Left wing for Dennis Holland, moving it on goal. Sidesteps a check, knocked down. It's loose in front, they score! On the rebound, I believe it was Kerry Clark who scored the goal. 7:51 to go in the first. The Golden Eagles have scored a goal. It's 3-1, Kansas City.
Great job by Kerry Clark coming in here. Dennis Holland makes a move on a defenseman. Gets him moving to the side. The puck comes back. Right here comes Kerry Clark into the picture. He's the trailer, and he makes no mistake. He throws it high over top of Irby. But great play by the Golden Eagles to come in and notch a goal here, getting them back into the hockey game 3-1.
Kerry Clark from Kelvington, Saskatchewan. His first goal of the playoffs from Dennis Holland. We will have another assist, I would think. Golden Eagles have cut the lead by two right now. And boy, Kerry Clark had 12 goals during the regular season, and what a worker.
Well, I'll tell you, Mike, that's a very, very important goal for the Golden Eagles to get. They certainly didn't want Kansas City to get up by four. That would have been a very, very deep hole to get out of.
Rich Chernomas, the other assist. Dennis Holland, the marker for Salt Lake. Kerry Clark's first of the playoffs at 12:09. Here's the play on left wing, and a chance for Carter. Backhander, and that's tipped away. There's an errant glove on the ice as the Blades work at the scrimmage, but it deflects all the way down deep into the Blade zone. 7:22 to go in the first period. Salt Lake have scored a goal to cut the lead. Here's the play to the near side. Forsland back to the point for Kevin Guy. Into the corner for Harris for Salt Lake. Back to the far side is Kevin Guy pinching in. His shot then steered aside by Irby. Eagles ferociously in a forecheck. Forsland has shot, but a stoppage of play to the right of the Kansas City goals. The net has been dislodged. Don't forget to order your tickets for Game A, April 14th, or Game B, April 16th. During this broadcast, and receive a $2 discount on all seats. Call 532-GOLD now. Operators are standing by. That's 532-GOLD. Good only during tonight's broadcast for the Eagles and the Blades on Tuesday and Thursday nights. Faceoff coming up deep to the right of the Kansas City goal. And the Eagles winning only four games during the regular season, but nine of the 16 games decided by one goal.
And probably more important, Mike, the last four times that these two teams met in the regular season, the Eagles came up with three victories, and that really got them some momentum coming into the series and put them in the frame of mind where they thought they could and know they can beat the Kansas City Blades.
Here's Darren Stolka's shot and steered aside by Irby. The Eagles trying to center one. Deasley a shot, deflected, and Irby gets a pace as Brian Deasley had a chance for the Golden Eagles cutting in deep.
Eagles doing a great job, Mike, now on the forecheck. A great cycle there. The puck comes out of the corner, finds Deasley right here in the slot. He takes it off the skate, then chips it up towards the net. What a great save by Irby.
Brian Deasley for the Salt Lake Golden Eagles. A first-round Flames pick back in 1987 out of the University of Michigan. And boy, a good scoring chance for the Golden Eagles, number 22. Scoring opportunity for the Golden Eagles, and a faceoff deep into the Blade zone. It is a line of C.J. Young, Todd Harkins, and Brian Deasley. C.J. Young on the left wing side, and the fans may remember Young for his performance in the Olympics, Randy, during the play in Albertville.
Well, he's a very important part of this team since he came back from the Olympics and joined the Golden Eagles. Bob Francis would like to see a little more production from him as he showed a couple of years ago.
Darren Stokes driving a skate save by Irby, and the Eagles are putting on more pressure to the Blade zone. But Gary Emmons in on net, shoots one, and a stick save. Sharples and played away to the left of the goal. And here is C.J. Young from Waven, Massachusetts. On right wing for Deasley, and his off wing scoops it towards the goal, and Irby himself leaves for Tom Peterson. Golden Eagles have cut the lead, and here's Stolkin on goal. Polkchek couldn't get a shot off, and the Blades break free. Gary Emmons in the center, able to play it on the right side for Jeff Medill. His shot blocked away and cleared back of the goal. Wertman winds but not out. Kolstad holds it in, spins it back of the goal, and Stoke now plays for Solik. A member of Kansas City last year. He also played at Muskegon. It's cleared to center, and the Blades have to go back into their own side. 6:07 to go in the first period. The Blades scored the first three. Kerry Clark scored the last one to cut the lead to 3-1. And Kansas City play it free into the Salt Lake zone. And Melrose hustles back. Right side, Kevin Dahl. At center ice, Holland, and he cranks it off the boards deep into the Blade zone. Here comes Kerry Clark, rumbling after the loose puck. It's dumped back into the far corner. Holland for the Golden Eagles. Backs it up towards the net, and Scremmen plays for the Blades. Eagles, Chernomaz in a forecheck, back of the goal, but tipped away. And Kravitz plays on the right side for Kansas City, and he scoops it into center ice. Golden Eagles have to go back. Here's Kevin Dahl, played for Team Canada in the Olympics. On the right side for Rich Chernomaz. Backs it up for Holland. In on goal. He is stripped of the puck and cleared into the center ice area. And back after Dahl for Melrose. On left wing, and he lifts it into the Kansas City zone, and the Blades have to go back. John Carter on the right side with Kansas City leading 3-1. In his center ice, skated off by Tim Harris. Kevin Melrose strips a Kansas City player, Evans, off the puck, and here comes Thomas Forslund down the right side into the Blades zone. Has Hafey, neat pass for Hafey, and on goal, a backhander, and that deflects wide. At the left point, Olsen able to play it for Forslund. Pass to the right point, Dahl shoots, save Irby. Big rebound, Hafey a shot, and that's blocked away. Hafey couldn't get a lot of lumber on that one, and Hafey controls the puck at the blue line, circling, trying to center one. Now plays it along the far hash box, and Forslund drops it left wing side. Hafey on goal, shoots it just wide. Great scoring chance for Sean Hafey, and he just missed the net.
Well, the Golden Eagles have really started to apply the pressure now, Mike. They're really playing great hockey 5-on-5. They have to stay out of that penalty box and keep going in the direction they are right now.
Here is Tom Peterson, plays it up the middle, and Ron Handy able to break this center into the Salt Lake zone. Handy, a wrist shot, and that caroms wide. This game opening up. Here's Handy tied up on the play, and the Eagles able to clear it to center. 3-1, Kansas City in the lead. The Eagles are starting to play a little bit better in the offensive zone. Here's Harkins trying to kick it free. Blades, however, just chip it to the blue line and up to center ice. Ed Courtney into the Salt Lake zone. Can't squeeze by Darryl Olsen, who made a nice poke check. And the play back of the goal deep into the Salt Lake zone. And here's Brian Deasley. Boy, the action is fast and furious right now as the Eagles muscle it free deep into the Kansas City zone. Claudio Scremmen after icing is the call with 3:39 to go in the first period. It's a 3-1 Kansas City lead. And we'll have more play-by-play coming up in game two in just a moment. Mike Barrack alongside Randy Busick here in Kansas City, Missouri. Kemper Arena, built in 1974. They housed an NHL team, the Kansas City Scouts. Here's the playback of the goal, and Darren Stolk plays it on left wing and on the near side for Kerry Clark. It bounces away, and Stolk on the right side. Headmans for Chernomaz, in for Holland, and he pokes it right back deep into the Blade zone. And Dean Kolstad able to hustle back at his own end. Right side for Jeff Medill, plays but not out. Stolk shoots one, and it caroms off a Kansas City player and bounces high into the corner. Eagles trying to dig it free. Here's Holland, McDonnelly, fire side. It could have been a penalty there, and Bob Francis is furious as the Blades clear it to center. Salt Lake trying to wind it right back in. And the Blades have had three chances on the power play already. The Eagles have not had one. Here's the play into center ice, and De Palma whirling around into the neutral zone, able to spin free and clears it into the Salt Lake zone. Medill way ahead of the play and a delayed offside, and the Eagles gain possession. 2:45 to go in the first period. Salt Lake down 3-1. Here's Kevin Wertman, able to poke it free. He led all a rookie defenseman in scoring this year in the IHL. Here's a play into the corner. Hafey in a forecheck. It's cleared away to the right wing point. Eagles hold it in. Here's Forslund. His shot gloved aside by Irby, and he holds on the far side. Eagles have cut the shots on goal on the last totals, 10-8 Kansas City. At one point, it was 8-1 Blades.
Boy, they really marched their way back, but this is the guy they have to get it past, Arthur Irby. Mike, he's been called upon 8 times to make some saves. He's done a great job, and he's very active outside of the net. He's like a seventh defenseman for the team, really. He moves the puck very well along the glass and up the boards to the forwards.
Great story about Arthur Irby. He left the Soviet national team to protest the independent movement in Latvia. Here's the play to the left wing side. Eagles, Kevin Gott, able to chip it back of the goal. Eagles, Hampi in a forecheck. Bad scramble back of the net. Harris trying to jostle it free and the puck on the mesh. And they freeze it with 2:14 to go in the first period. Kansas City up 3-1. And Randy, they'll always stop it on that play back of the goal when it's in the mesh area.
Well, there's not much you can do, Mike, to keep the puck moving unless the goaltender pokes it off from behind the net. Things are starting to get physical now. Here comes Hafey into the boards hard, throwing his weight around. Tim Harris back out there to move the puck around to the front, but it goes up in a net and a stoppage of play.
Here's Olsen, a shot from the point and steered aside by Irving. Matt scramble back of the goal. We're going to have a penalty on the play, and let's see if this one's going to go against Kansas City. A holding call, and I think it will be against the Blades. 2:06 to go in the first. Kansas City leading 3-1, and this is Salt Lake Golden Eagles playoff hockey. Salt Lake Golden Eagles go on their first power play. Sandis Ozolinch, a holding penalty at 17:54. Salt Lake in the power play this year, 68 for 362, ranking sixth out of 10 teams in the power play. And a great chance here to get back into this game. Here's the play at the left wing point. Darryl Olsen with the Blades up 3-1, moves in. Hands for Chernomaz. His shot blocked away on the one-time chance. At the near side, it is C.J. Young. Holding on for Salt Lake, back of the net. Chips it free on this power play. It's the Blades penalty killing. Exquisite this year. Here's the play at the left wing point. Olsen shoots and just deflected wide by Chernomaz. But the Eagles have had some dandy chances. Here's Chernomaz, cuts in front. Partially fans on it. Wortman pinching in. Winds it free to Forslund. Back to the point for Wortman. Able to play it left wing point for Olsen. Across for Young. Trying to center one, does. Right wing point for Wortman. Unable to hold it in. And the Eagles have to regroup at center, and Olsen able to work free. Here is Darryl Olsen in across the line. Right side for C.J. Young. Pulls up for Salt Lake, trying to work it free. Trying to kick it along the boards. They try and freeze it there. And finally, it's worked free into the corner. Chernomaz for Salt Lake with 56 seconds to go in the penalty. Able to play it to the right wing side. Under a minute to go in the period. Olsen at the point. Hands it for Young off his stick. But Chernomaz, back of the goal for Young. Cuts in front. Centers one. But tipped away at the right point. Wortman for Salt Lake. On this Eagle power play to Olsen. Across for Young. Fans on his pass the three into the center ice area. And the forward Kravitz for Kansas City back free into the neutral zone. In with Emmons, trying to maneuver free. Knock off the puck by Olsen, who beautifully plays it into the corner. The Eagles have four players along the far side to try and work it free, but Kansas City's Kolstad gains possession, and he scoops it into the Salt Lake zone. 16 seconds to go in the penalty, 20 seconds to go in the period. Blades leading 3-1. Here's Wortman on left wing, able to charge to center. Winds it right back into the Kansas City end. Irvam still plays it, but not out, Guy. Oh, it is called an offside. Had Kevin Guy been able to keep the puck in, Eagles would have had a scoring chance and a stop with 9 seconds to go in the period. Bob Francis has to be a little more pleased by the fact that the Eagles have put more pressure on Artur Irvam.
He definitely have, Mike, and it was a great power play for the Golden Eagles. They had good puck possession, moved it around, had a couple of quality scoring opportunities. Unfortunately, they were able to find the mesh behind Irvam.
Golden Eagles have not won a playoff game since April 30th of 1990. They've gone 8 consecutive games without a loss. That was a 5-4 overtime win at the Salt Palace as Tim Sweeney knocked one home past Darren Pang, who is now a broadcaster for the Chicago Blackhawks. Goaltender for Indianapolis. Here's the play at center with 6 seconds to go in the period. Eagles back after it and at his own defense is Kevin Guy. Waltz is in the center. Long shot. Irby the save, and that's it. The buzzer sounds, signaling the end of the first period. Kansas City open to a 3-0 lead. Eagles come back to make it 3-1, and a very big goal by Kerry Clark.
Well, Kansas City had a lot of power play opportunities early in this game, and they made good on all of them, and that really turned out to be the big difference in this period. The Golden Eagles picked it up towards the end. But, hey, we got another period coming up.
Okay, 3-1 Blades through 20, and we'll come back with our between periods activities in just a moment.
From Kansas
Welcome back, everyone, to Kemper Arena in Kansas City. After the first period, the Blades scoring three power play goals and have a lead of 3-1 after 20 minutes of play here tonight. I'm Mike Barrick, and I hope you're enjoying the action. Glad you've had a chance to get an opportunity to see the Golden Eagles in postseason play. And it's been a very interesting 1991-92 season. The Golden Eagles finishing in fourth place in the Western Division, able to make the playoffs for the 15th consecutive year. And let's take a look back at this past season for the Salt Lake Golden Eagles.
The 1991-92 Salt Lake Golden Eagles season will always be remembered for some exciting moments, but most likely is the year of the Delta Center.
First hockey game, the first athletic event here at the Delta Center.
We're just excited that we have a chance tonight to open up this building with a hockey game.
Over a quarter of a million fans supported the hockey team in its first year of operation in the new building, and it surely didn't take long for the Eagles to excite the fans in their home opener October 16th.
It takes 53 seconds into the Delta Center, and who else but Rich Chernomaz?
Although the Eagles had a new home, things weren't bright in the early going, with Salt Lake gaining just one win in their first 11 games of the season. But things turned around in November with a sparkling 10-3 mark. The roller coaster season would continue for the rest of the year.
We had to come with the realization of what's going to make us successful, and that took a lot of searching. We acquired that identity. That's by getting the puck deep, keeping it simple, and playing hard down low. And we were very disciplined defensively, and the process really came about. We won 8 games in a row, and we were off of the track then, and I think the confidence level improved immensely.
One of the bright spots all season was the play of 5'8" rookie centerman Sean Hafey. The graduate of Michigan State led Eagle players in scoring, as well as finishing with a whopping 41 goals. Perhaps the most thrilling play came February 8th, with the game winding down to the bitter end.
Hafey now to cross the line. In, shoots, he scores! Sean Hafey with 2 seconds left in the game! Unbelievable! The Eagles have a lead, 3-2!
The play of another rookie, Jason Mazzotti, would hardly go unnoticed by the Eagles faithful. Mazzotti was a workhorse in goal, playing in 52 contests, ranking second in the IHL, and finishing fifth among league goaltenders in goals against average. Although the Eagles finished dead last in league scoring, second-year center Todd Harkins doubled his goal output from year one with a 32-goal campaign to finish second in team scoring. While Salt Lake didn't win games every night, they proved to be among the league's toughest in winning their fights. Well-known enforcers Kerry Clark, Richard Zemlak, Darren Banks, and Paul Cruz helped Salt Lake to a league-leading high of 121 major penalties. These totals helped the opposition to score 98 power play goals against the Eagles, prompting coach Bob Francis to lecture his pugilists in the penalty box. One of the last remaining questions was whether team captain Rich Chernomaz could break the all-time franchise goal record set by former Eagle forward Doug Palazzari. He finally achieved the milestone April 2nd against Phoenix.
It's a nice record to have. Doug Palazzari was a great player when he played here in Salt Lake, and that's something I'll cherish for the rest of my life.
Despite a final record of 33-40-9, the Eagles finished with points in 5 of their final 8 games to secure a playoff spot for the 15th consecutive year and headed into postseason play in quest for the Turner Cup.
Well, here you have a look back at the 1991-92 season for Salt Lake, and if they have a chance for the Turner Cup, they're going to have to come back against Kansas City in this series. They're down 3-1 at the end of the first period here, and down 1-0 in the best of 7 so far. Hope you're enjoying the action. We'll come back with more here at Kemp Arena in Kansas City in just a moment. Welcome back to Kemp Arena here in Kansas City, Missouri. I'm Mike Barrack alongside Randy Busick. The Kansas City Blades have a 3-1 lead at the end of the first period. Randy, the Eagles found themselves down, but mostly because of power play opportunity.
Definitely. I think that Coach Bobby Francis would like to just erase the first 8 minutes of this hockey game. The Golden Eagles got themselves into penalty problems, and the Kansas City Blades took advantage of that, jumping out into a big 3-0 lead.
Well, the Blades jumped on top very early, and it was Larry De Palma who scored the first one last night, does it again this evening.
Well, the puck just skitters loose over to De Palma, who's streaking to the net. Nobody picks him up. He's all alone against Sharples. He makes one small move and throws it between the legs of Sharples, 1-0.
And then the Blades scored again. It was Gary Emmons who was their leading point scorer all year long.
Well, Emmons gets a little bit of room on the outside. He walks in towards the center, and he lets one go high over top of Sharples' shoulder, and that makes it 2-0.
Well, the Eagles and the Blades, at that point, the Eagles had some chances, but Kansas City got another power play chance and then buried a goal to make it 3-0.
Well, that was a big goal for Kansas City to get up by three. It definitely put the Eagles behind the eight ball, but they were able to fight their way back and really turn things around in the second half of that first period.
Yeah, the Eagles at one point were outshot 8-1. They came back and made it a game of it. Kerry Clark eventually scored, and the Golden Eagles in the game by a score of 3-1. But the third goal by Michael Kravitz giving Kansas City another power play marker.
Well, they really moved the puck around nice. Mike ends up going down low into the corner, and just a little bit of a give and go to Kravitz, who makes a snapshot, puts Kansas City up 3-0.
And the Eagles coming back to make it a score of 3-1 as the Golden Eagles' Kerry Clark would put one in just a few moments later to give the Golden Eagles their first goal of the night.
Well, Dennis Holland moving in on a defenseman. Everybody goes to where the puck is. Nobody picks up Kerry Clark coming in late on the play. He's a trailer. He lets a quick snapper go high over top of Air Bay's shoulders. And that was a very, very important goal because it really got some momentum going for the Golden Eagles and got them back into this hockey game.
Hard to believe a couple of years ago, Kerry Clark played for the Phoenix Roadrunners and was not a fan favorite in Salt Lake, but in a couple of seasons in an Eagle uniforms, fans have really enjoyed his rough and tumble style of play.
Well, he's not known to be a goal scorer, but the one he got tonight is definitely going to help out. Obviously, when a guy comes in and causes a lot of havoc with your players, not going to be very favorable to the fans, but Salt Lake has really put their arms around Kerry Clark. He's been a great addition to the team this year.
Well, the Golden Eagles in postseason play for the 15th consecutive year, and Randy, playoffs, no real surprise for fans in Salt Lake. It seems they've been able to be used to it, and the Eagles really had a scramble to make postseason play this year.
Well, it made it tough, but it makes it interesting, too. They're a desperate team right now, and they're playing that way, and it makes it very good for the Golden Eagles because they're a team with a lot of character, and they have a good chance to prove it again here tonight by staging a comeback.
Well, hope you're enjoying the action here tonight. And for some of our newer fans to the game of hockey, we're going to take a look at our Ardell Brown offside call, give you a chance to see what hockey's all about. The Salt Lake Golden Eagles present the three rules of hockey, the main rules that control the game, as demonstrated by Golden Eagle players Kevin Wortman, Dennis Holland, and Darren Banks. Sponsored by Ardell Brown Recreational Vehicles. Rule number one is blue line offsides. The puck must always cross the blue line into the attacking zone ahead of any offensive player. A pass is legal if the offensive player receives the pass behind the blue line or if he receives a pass while straddling the blue line. However, if an offensive player receives a pass after crossing the blue line into the attacking zone, it results in a face-off. And I hope you enjoyed the segment on the offsides of fans in Salt Lake. We have a lot of old-time Eagle fans. We have some newer fans as well.
Well, the rules of hockey are kind of funny, Mike, changing all the time and hard to keep up with sometimes. The pace is very fast, but anytime you get a chance of an explanation on the screen, it makes things a lot easier to follow the play.
Well, the Eagles trail the Blades 3-1 at the end of the first period, and we'll come back with a CNN Sports update in just a moment. Welcome back to Kemper Arena in Kansas City. The Eagles trail the Kansas City Blades by 2-3. Three power play goals, the difference here tonight for the Blades.
Well, definitely has been the whole change in this game, Mike. The whole start here, you see the stats right now. 3-1 the score, shots a net, 10 all. But the power plays are the main difference, Mike. The Kansas City Blades getting three power play goals, and that's been the whole story.
The PAW computer statistics here at Kemper Arena between the Eagles and the Blades with Kansas City leading by a count of a two-goal advantage at 3-1. Scott Sharples giving up the three goals in the opening stanza. Archer Irbe, the netminder for Kansas City, yielding just one. Well, Golden Eagle fans, the Fanatic Fan Contest, sponsored by Delta Airlines, will take place every home playoff game. Dress up, paint your face, make a sign, get wild, do whatever it takes. During the game, the Eagles will choose the fanatic fan of the game, and that person will win a trip for two on Delta Airlines anywhere Delta flies in the continental United States. Games 1 and 2, Tuesday and Thursday nights. Game 3 and 4 overall at the Delta Center. Don't forget to order your tickets for Game A or B. Game A, April 14th. Game B, April 16th. During this broadcast, and receive a $2 discount on all seats. Call 532-GOLD now. Operators are standing by. That's 532-GOLD. Good only during tonight's broadcast. Eagles in the first period against the Blades were outshot by a mark of, well, actually, Salt Lake outshot, as we talked about, Kansas City 11-10 in the first period. And immediately the Eagles gained possession back of the goal. In the last 8 minutes, the Eagles outshot Kansas City 9-2. At one point, they were down 8-1 in the shots on goal department as the Eagles play the puck, and Kevin Dahl able to whip it on the opposite side. Sandis Olsalinch, his shot to caroms off a Salt Lake defender, and Salt Lake's Kevin Melrose leaves it behind the goal, and Chernomaz able to play it for the moment. John Carter into forecheck for Kansas City. Able to play it to the side of the goal. Blade center one, but tipped away. Carter shoots it just wide. Sean Afey had a chance like that of the first period. He also missed the target. And back after it is John Carter in his own side. He played for an NCAA championship at RPI. Able to leaves it for Olsalinch into the center ice turn. Kansas City played the puck in across the line. Claudio Scrimmon backhands it towards the Salt Lake net. A minute gone into the second period. And the Blades with a two-goal advantage. Here's Salt Lake Sean Afey trying to work it free, but Dean Kolstad able to cue it into the corner, and the Eagles come up with the puck on the right side. Tim Harris plays, but not out. Kolstad at the point. His shot deflects awry, and the Eagles' Afey leaves it free into the neutral zone. Sean Afey to center. Cranks it right back deep into the Kansas City zone. Into forecheck Thomas Forslund. The puck squirts free, and Forslund, for the moment, able to wind it into the corner for Harris. Playing the Kansas City end. Eagles trying to work it free, but Emmons on the outlet pass, stolen by Hafey. Cuts in, backs it up behind the goal for Harris as the Eagles cycling in the offensive zone. Forslund and Kolstad collide. Emmons and Hafey battle for it, and Olsen comes up with the puck and shoots one in front for Hafey. In on goal, a backhand! Save Irby! A glove save on the great scoring chance by Sean Hafey.
Great job by the Golden Eagles, Mike, to gain control. Deep inside the Kansas City zone, here's Hafey, gets that puck out in front. He's right in the top of the circles all by himself. He lets a whipper go from the backhand, but Irby gets a glove on it.
Sean Hafey for Salt Lake, a first pick by the Calgary Flames in the 1989 supplemental draft out of Michigan State. Faceoff will come up, circle to the left of Arthur Irby, 11 saves tonight. A 10th round North Star pick in 1986. Faceoff will come up to the left of the goal as the Blades play the puck. He was acquired in the dispersal draft with the San Jose Sharks, joining the National Hockey League. Here's the Kevin Wordman shot, caroms wide. And then on the right side, Ed Courtney trying to work it free. They fight for it and freeze it with 2:06 gone into the second. Blades leading by a count of 3-1. And we really haven't talked about it much, Randy, but the Blades are missing quite a few players tonight. And we will talk about it as the night progresses, but they called up five players to the San Jose Sharks, and including their goaltender, Wade Flaherty, who would have been the backup tonight. And Randy, can you sing a little song there?
Do you know the way to San Jose?
Yeah, sing a little bars for us here.
Well, why don't you hum for me?
We'll do it here. Here's the play on the right wing side, but five players called up to San Jose, and as the National Hockey League strike concludes, and the San Jose Sharks still have to finish out their NHL year. They have three games remaining. Here's a play to the Salt Lake zone, but Darren Stolk gets a stick up on a Kansas City player, and I think we'll have a penalty against Stolk as the Blades were working into the offensive zone.
Well, it looks probably be a high-sticking penalty against Stolk. He gets a stick high up on Courtney. He's trying to just block him off and get him into the boards. Lifts him up high here as they come off the glass. Whoops, right there. Down he goes, and there goes the arm of Derek Martin. Right there, he had a good look at it. 2-minute minor.
Darren Stolk for the Salt Lake Golden Eagles in his first year. Last season, he played with Muskegon and Kansas City. 2:29 the time of the penalty, and the Blades will go on their fourth power play, and they are perfect so far, going 3-for-3.
Well, Mike, you know, the Golden Eagles are playing spectacular 5-on-5. This is where they're getting into their problems when they have to face these power plays.
Already in this series, game two tonight, there have been 11 man advantage chances for the Blades. Seven last night, and tonight the fourth. Faceoff will come up deep to the right of the Salt Lake goal. Brand new mask for Scott Sharples, and it has to be one of the most attractive in the league.
Well, you know, the goalies take pride in that. They have a lot of fun painting him up, and feel that sometimes it could be intimidating for the shooters when they bear down on him.
Here's the play now on the Blades power play. Kansas City trying to dig it free, and Chernomaz on the left wing side. Can't clear the zone. Blades hold it in. Here's Scremmen now at the point. Shoots one, and Sharples able to hold on as Scremmen let it fly from the blue line. That mask cost about $700. They actually had it molded to his face as Scott Sharples was Warren Sharples, but now going as Scott.
A little bit of high technology with those masks, Mike. Ask Glenn Hall about that. I don't know what he used to use, a piece of corduroy or something strapped to his head. I'm not sure.
Here's the playback of the goal. The Golden Eagles in this game, down by two. As the Blades on the power play, Courtney throws it across to the right wing point. Scremmen shoots, and he just deflects it wide, and then actually into the far side with, I think, the second time of this game, the puck has gone underneath the boards here in Kansas City. These Blades playing in their second year in Kansas City at Kemper Arena, and this building housing a lot of basketball tournaments, but that space behind the net, Randy, strange to see.
Well, you know, and it could cause a lot of problems for a goaltender who leaves his crease to go out and play the puck. If it caroms off that boards in a funny way, it could bounce right out in front of the net and give the opposition a golden scoring opportunity.
3:03 gone into the second period. Kansas City another 1:26 on the power play. Their first playoff victory for Kansas City since 1979. They were known as the Kansas City Red Wings back then. They also played as the Kansas City Blues and 2 years as the National Hockey League's Kansas City Scouts. And boy, they were a team that finished in last place two consecutive years, and that was it in the NHL. Eagles clear it all the way deep into the Blade zone, and Kansas City's ear base sets it up for Claudio Scremmen, back of his net. Here is Kansas City's Scremmen, who played 13 games with current San Jose this year. Clears but not out. Chernomaz steals, works it for Holland, but the pass a little bit off the mark. Now Holland for Chernomaz, eludes the defenseman Scremmen and beautifully drops it to center, but it's off a leg, and Courtney into the Salt Lake zone. He's tripped up, and the Eagles clear it right back into the neutral zone, and Chernomaz wheels free down the right side. He shoots. Oh, and it just deflects wide. Ricochets off the backboards to center, and Salt Lake pound it right back in. 40 seconds left in the Stoke penalty. 3:50 gone into the second period. Blades leading by a 3-1 count. On left wing, Peterson in the center. Ahead for Courtney. Out of the goal, Sharples himself plays on left wing, and Thomas Forslund just cues it all the way deep into the Blade zone. And Arthur Irbe able to play it on left wing, and Dwayne Joyce circles back for the Blades. Eagles down by two, but only 16 seconds to go in the penalty. Here's Carter down the right side. In with Kravitz and Lappin. Carter now back of the goal, skated off beautifully by Darryl Olsen. However, the Blades come up with a puck to the right of the Salt Lake goal. Carter down for Kansas City to Joyce at the left wing point. Joyce across, blocked away, and the forward Carter takes over. Eagles have killed off the penalty, and finally it's wound free to center. The first power play they've killed off here tonight. And Stoke after the Kansas City played it offside. 4:38 gone into the second period. Blades winning by a score of 3-1, and that's a key penalty kill for the Golden Eagles. Perhaps this will change the momentum in favor of Salt Lake.
Well, Mike, 5-on-5. The Golden Eagles are playing spectacular tonight. They want to just continue in that way. When you take penalties, it breaks up that momentum and continuity. So, you know, penalties not only put your team in a disadvantage as far as the men on the ice, but also as far as the way the ball's rolling in the hockey game.
Faceoff coming deep to the Kansas City goal to the right of Arthur Irbe. Todd Harkins to drop against Gary Emmons. The forward line, Todd Harkins with Carl Cruz and Brian Deasley. And this troika has been together, Randy, since last year.
Well, they really complement each other's style, Mike. They play well together, and they know where each other is on the ice at all times.
Here is the play back of the goal. Deasley trying to work it free in the Blades. Emmons able to gain possession. He played at Northern Michigan University. Same school as Salt Lake defenseman Darryl Olsen. And the play back of the goal. Eagles trying to work it free. It's punched on the boards, but Emmons deep into the Salt Lake zone. Hands it free in front for Kolstad. Pawed down by Wertman, and he throws it into the corner. Harkins gains possession and pokes it deep into the Blade zone. Ryan Beasley fiercely in a forecheck, but Kolstad beats him to it. Then Eagles in a forecheck. They try and work it free. Beasley was going for the puck. Upends Kolstad and a penalty coming up on the play, I believe. Although Beasley appeared to be going to yank the puck away from Kolstad and ended up hauling him down.
Well, Deasley's going in on the forecheck, hooking Kolstad. He misses him there, but this time when he goes to slash a stick, he hits Kolstad up on the side of the facial area, and he's going to go into the penalty box again.
Well, the worry right now for the Eagles is the potential of a five-minute penalty. If Kolstad were to be cut on the play, the Eagles would be short of hand for 5 minutes. Deasley to the box, and Paul Cruz talking things over with Derek Martin. That perhaps could be the discussion right now. A slashing penalty on the near side.
Well, and probably a good thing for the Golden Eagles. It's only going to be registered as a two-minute minor and not anything worse than that. So another big penalty kill for the Golden Eagles. They definitely don't want Kansas City to jump ahead again for a three-goal lead. So a big kill, and Bobby Francis looks quite concerned right now.
While the Golden Eagles will be playing Kansas City Tuesday night at the Delta Center, order your tickets for Game A, Tuesday, April 14th, or Game B, April 16th, Thursday night during this broadcast, and receive a $2 discount on all seats. That's 532-GOLD. Call operators are standing by, and this offer is good only during tonight's broadcast. Golden Eagles down 3-1. The penalty Deasley for slashing at 5-12. The fifth power play for Kansas City. And the 12th already in this series. The Eagles lost last night, giving up 7 power play chances and 5 more tonight. And the play back of the goal. And Ozalinch able to gain possession. He's only 19 years of age. Able to play it free in the opposite wing. And tipped by the Blades deep into the Salt Lake zone. Scott Sharples plays it. Blades trying to work it free. And it's controlled by Emmons for Kansas City. Back to the point, Ozalinch in for Dwayne Joyce. Hands it free to Emmons, trying to circle in front. Whacked by Holland for the moment. Then Joyce to hands for Emmons. His shot blocked and kicked away by Dahl. It squirts free along the far side of the back of the net. Melrose trying to dig it free. Dahl for Salt Lake after it, and Kansas City wind it to the right wing point for Joyce. Shoots and a kick save made by Sharples and cleared away by the Eagles.
Good job by the Golden Eagles to grab that rebound and throw it all the way down the ice and kill some time off this clock.
Thomas Forslund up front with C.J. Young to kill it off now. On the back line, Kevin Dahl and Kevin Melrose. Kansas City play the puck into Palma now. Swivels into the Salt Lake zone with Medill. Left wing side for Joyce, and he's able to cue it back of the goal. Under a minute to go on the penalty. Blades trying to work it free. Joyce for Medill. He shot. Pad save. Sharples. And the rebound skips wide. De Palma trying to center one. Forslund for Salt Lake trying to muscle it free. And the native of Sweden just picks an opening and clears it all the way down. 30 seconds to go in the penalty. And Joyce plays back of his net. Golden Eagles down by 2. Carey Clark, the lone Salt Lake goal in the first period. Here's J.F. Quintet at center. Check. Hafey still trying to center one, but Scremin plays for Kansas City as the penalty winding down. Handy on right wing. Able to wind it for Quintet. Hafey stays with him. The puck squirts free to the left wing side. Peterson to the near side for Evans. Backs it up for Quintet. Into the corner for Evans. 2 seconds to go in the penalty. Deasley is back on. The Eagles have killed off 2 in a row. Here's the playback of the goal. Blades, Quintet in deep. Trying to play it free on the far side. It's centered, but tipped away at the top of the circle. Peterson has shot. That caroms wide. Blades putting on some pressure. It's loose in front. Sharples gets a pace, as I believe it was Quintet who tried to stuff it in the short side and now pushing and shoving to the left of the Salt Lake goal.
Great job by Sharples, Mike, to keep his angle, get a hold of that puck and get a whistle so the Golden Eagles could get a change here. The puck moves quickly from the point out in front of the net, and they're camped out to the size of Kansas City player. He has a good angle to stuff it, but Sharples was right there to get a glove on it.
Scott Sharples played at the University of Michigan and had another good save into the Salt Lake zone, and Quintet was parked right to the left of the goal.
Well, I'll tell you, having that big reach like Sharples has helps out at times like that, Mike. He was out towards the front of the net when the puck skipped off to the side. Sharples was able to make that big long reach and get a hold of that puck.
Scott Sharples looking for his first playoff victory for Salt Lake. He played 4 games last season against the Phoenix Roadrunners, and he suffered 3 setbacks and would love to pick up his first IHL playoff win here tonight. Shots on goal 15-13 in favor of the Blades, and that's not too bad considering Kansas City having 5 power play chances. Here's the play on right wing, and Harkins able to leave it free for Deasley. Left wing for a streaking Cruz. Carter all over him. Now Cruz back of the net. He is knocked down. Scrimmon caught up in the play also, and Harkins deep in a forecheck for Solik. Here's the native of Cleveland. Todd Harkins for Paul Cruz. They try and freeze it there, and finally it skips to the forward Carter. Eagles Cruz steals, scores! Paul Cruz stole it right off the stick of John Carter, and with one sweep, able to score a goal, and it's 3-2 Kansas City.
Well, I'll tell you, Mike, that's the way the Golden Eagles are going to come out with a victory here tonight. Just a bunch of hard work by this line. Paul Cruz doing a great job, strips Carter of the puck, makes a quick spin. I don't think Urbay was expecting it, but he found the far side, and now the lead's cut 3-2. The Eagles are back into it, Mike. Great job by Cruz.
Paul Cruz spent some time with the Calgary Flames this year. He scored his first National Hockey League goal, Randy, this year against Ed Belfour, the Chicago Blackhawks.
Well, he's had quite a few memorable experiences this year, Mike, and what a big goal to get his team back into this hockey game now. 12 minutes to go in this period. Great job by Harkins to get the puck over to Cruz, and Cruz put it in the net.
Okay, the Eagles dump it up into the stands. 3-2, Blades in the lead. The Eagles have made a game out of it. We'll come back with more in the second period in just a moment. Mike Barak alongside Randy Busick at Kemper Inn in Kansas City. The Eagles battling from a 3-0 deficit. It's 3-2.
Well, Mike, they're right back into this, and it's going to be very interesting now.
Here are the Eagles with Holland, Chernomaz, and Clark. Clark scored the first one for Solik, and Cruz the second. Here's the play to center ice. Emmons a long shot, and squeezing the pads together, Scott Sharples to hold on into the Solik goal. And Scott Sharples, after giving up those three first period power play goals, has not yielded a Kansas City score.
Well, a little bit of a slow start, and it was too bad the very first penalty went to Sharples for throwing it high over top of the glass. He just went up on end, and he was a victim of that. But long shots like this, goalies don't mind at all, especially when they can see him. It's Sharples right in the breadbasket. No problem holding on to that one.
Last night, Darrell Olsen scored a goal from that range into the center ice area off Arthur Irbay.
Well, not too often you're going to get one of those against Irbay, but Irbay is very active outside of his net. And he got caught trying to cheat and stop that puck, and Olsen threw it at the net and beat him.
Golden Eagles have cut the lead 3-2. 11 and a half minutes left in the second period. Jeff Bedell, poke check on left wing, and Holland comes up with a puck. Headmans for Chernomaz, but breaking it up is Dean Kolstad on left wing. Chips into the neutral zone, and Clark leaves it back for Melrose on the left wing side. Here's the Eagles. Clark bumps it to the blue line. Now he smacks it into the blade zone. Irbay makes the stop, and as soon as they touch it, an offside, a delayed offside at the Kansas City blue line. The Eagles perhaps may have gotten Irbay off his game with those two goals.
Well, you have to start thinking about that. Irbay doesn't give up very many goals in a hockey game when his goals against was under three for the whole season. So if you can get three or four past him, you may get him second guessing himself. You never know. But this year he let in eight in one game, so it's possible.
He played 13 games with the San Jose Sharks and also gave up eight this season in a game against the Detroit Red Wings. Here's the play on the right wing side. Courtney trying to work it free, but it's well in the center, and Kevin Guy able to spank it right back in. 10:57 left in the second. Eagles have cut the lead 3-2 with a late goal in the first and one here in the second stanza. And Rick Lessard, who's played sparingly tonight, able to wind it right back into the Salt Lake zone. A member of a team for Salt Lake that made it to the Turner Cup Finals. Here's the play in front. A chance for the forward Quintan, blocked away, and Salt Lake trying to play it free. Kansas City's Courtney for Quintan, a shot, and steered aside by Sharples, and Salt Lake's Guy rims it on left wing, but not out. Blades hold it in. Quick shot deflecting, and Sharples able to make the save with 10:25 to go in the second period. Scott Sharples and the Golden Eagles trailing by one at 3-2. Scott Sharples for the Salt Lake Golden Eagles last year had a terrific season for the Salt Lake hockey team. He had a total of 37 games played at 21 victories. It's been kind of a rocky year for him.
Well, I'm sure he's hoping that the playoffs this year go better than they did last year also, Mike.
Faceoff will come up deep to the left for the goal. 10:25 to go in the middle period. John Carter can't see it with his helmet on, but he sports a Mohawk haircut for the postseason. Here's the play on the far side. Scrimming a shot and a stick save Sharples. He's been red hot since the first period. Here's Olzelinch, able to flip it high in the air into the corner, and Salt Lake's Cruz. There's Benatout, scrimmage shot. That caroms wide. Eagles play it, but not out. Blades trying to work it free, and finally, Salt Lake play at the center. And here comes Harkins into the Blade zone. Poke check, then wound right back into the Kansas City territory. And his second round Sharks pick this year, Olzelinch shoots it off the boards deep into the Salt Lake zone. Workman after it, and as he touches it, icing is the call with 9:52 to go in the second. The Blades leading 3-2, and we'll come back with a little bit more from Kemper Arena in just a moment. Total of 9:52 to go in the second period. Paul Cruz scores the middle period goal. The Golden Eagles have cut it to within one.
Well, the Golden Eagles really have a lot of momentum going right now, Mike. They've carried the play for the most part since the first 10 minutes of the first period.
Dennis Holland with Rich Chernomans and Kerry Clark is the forward line. And Larry DePalma headmans for Gary Emmons into the center ice area. For DePalma, back in front of the goal. Medill after it and tipped wide of the target. Good scoring chance for the Blades. Here's a chance for DePalma and a delayed penalty, I believe, against Salt Lake as Holland touches it. It looks like a high stick call deep into the Salt Lake territory, and Dennis Holland can't believe it as Derek Martin skates to the near side.
Well, another two-minute minor. Dennis Holland heading off towards a penalty box to serve this one, and the Golden Eagles again going into the shorthanded situation.
Well, a key power play coming up for the Kansas City Blades. 3-2 Kansas City in the lead. We'll come back with the Blades power play in just a moment. Six to one.
Start using your body instead of the goddamn stick.
Hurry.
Mike Barrack alongside Randy Busick. Dennis Holland for high sticking at 10:28, but Salt Lake's Forslund working free. The Eagles are short a man. Here's Forslund. The Eagles, Forslund able to dump it and eat some time off the clock. 20 seconds gone into the penalty. Kansas City on their sixth power play. The Eagles have had only one man advantage chance all night long. And despite that fact, it's only a one-goal game. The Eagles trying to work it free on the left wing side. Olsen works against Emmons, plays but not out. Colston at the point, holds it in, flips it in the slot. Sharples able to pounce on top, and rather than throw it to a defenseman or a forward, he elects to hold on into the Salt Lake territory.
Well, I'll tell you, it's going to be very tough for Scott Sharples if he has to face any more penalties. Very tiring for him to stand in there and face these shots time and time again. 20-15 now, the Kansas City Blades starting to pull ahead of the Golden Eagles in that category again, and solely due to those power play opportunities.
Face off deep into the Salt Lake zone. Ron Handy, who played on an Adams Cup championship with the now defunct Indianapolis Checkers, to draw up against Sean Hafey. Eagles clear it, but not out. Blades hold it in. Peterson shoots it just wide. It ricochets off the backboards and cleared away for Chernomaz. Eagles trying to dig it free. It's wound right back into the back of the Salt Lake goal. Handy with Courtney all over him. Kevin Guy. They scramble for it. Eagles trying to work it free, and the Blades come up with the puck. Here is the forward Keaton. Plays it back into the far corner, and Hafey unable to gain possession. The Blades come up with the puck. Keaton for Kansas City. Yanks it for Handy. Cuts in front. Plays to the side of the goal. In front of the net now. Tipped away and cleared outside the blue line. And the Blades have to go back with 40 seconds to go in the penalty.
Good job by the Golden Eagles making a change. Very important for them to get that puck down the ice and get some fresh men out there.
Here is Handy now. Artfully into the center ice area. Works free in the center and back of the play. A penalty coming up as Peterson and Hafey have some words along the far side.
Peterson and Hafey doing a little bit of pushing and shoving, but it's going to be Peterson heading off into the penalty box. 2 minutes for high sticking, a retaliation penalty. Mike, time and time again, you see it. The referee will miss the first shot, but he never misses that retaliation.
And the Eagles have had plenty of those this year, but a great chance for Salt Lake to go on the power play. For 31 seconds, the teams will be at even strength. Peterson a high stick at 11:57, and Salt Lake will have their second power play chance of the night.
Well, as the clock starting to wind down here in the second period, just over 8 minutes to go here, a great chance for the Golden Eagles to tie things up. And who knows, going into the third period, that's exactly where you want to be when you're in the visitors' arena, is just give yourself a chance to win, and that's by keeping that score really tight.
These two teams will meet Tuesday night, 7 o'clock at the Delta Center, also Thursday evening for sure. The Eagles could pull out a win here. They would guarantee themselves to the game next Saturday night also. Here's the play at the defense, and Kevin Dahl able to hold on for Sulink. Golden Eagles in an even strength situation, four skaters aside. Here's the play on the left wing shot, and Melrose gets away from Kravitz and plays to center, out of the reach of a streaking Cruz, and then back after Olsenich on the right wing side. Here's Cruz in a forecheck with Harkins to the side of the goal. Blades get crossed up. Dahl's pass back to Melrose outside the blue line. 3 seconds left in the Holland penalty. Now Holland is back on. It's a man advantage chance for Sulink. Here come the Eagles. Into center ice, it's Harkins. Into the blade zone. Poked away at the defense and then wound into the center ice area. And Carter just pinballs it off the boards deep into the Sulink zone. 7:19 to go in the second period. Eagles have scored two in a row and have cut it to 3-2. And here comes Darryl Olsen. Lead pass, Chernomaz, just out of his reach as Cherno was going for the breakaway, Randy.
Well, hey, that's a play by Bobby Francis. When that player can sneak in behind a defenseman, stretch out the D and get a long pass in, you never know.
Here is Solik's Olsen now. Breezes to center. Left wing for the Eagles rookie Wertman to Olsen. Back on a give and go to Wertman. Hands it free. On all seats. Call 532-GOLD now. Operators are standing by. That's 532-GOLD. Good only during tonight's game. And the faceoff will come outside the blue line. 8 seconds to go on the penalty. Good puck movement, Randy, but no scoring play.
They had great possession, Mike, but I'll tell you, the Kansas City Blades are playing very strong in their penalty-killing units, making it tough for the Golden Eagles to get inside that box and create some good scoring opportunities.
Here is Solik Diesling, a forecheck, in behind the goal for Harkins, front of center one. It's high in the air and actually up into the stands. But 6 minutes to go in the middle period. Kansas City leading by a count of 3-2. And sometimes you see those pucks flying to the stands, but that was an easy one for the youngster.
Boy, is there a happy guy or what? He's got something for the backyard to go out and play with.
Faceoff will come up to the Kansas City zone, and Derek Martin skating to the penalty box area, and perhaps we're going to have a penalty into the near side. He's escorting a Kansas City player to the box. We may have a misconduct penalty on the play.
Possibly. Tom Peterson very upset about the way things are going. There's a 2-minute minor showing up on the board, so probably, I'm guessing, would be...
Unsportsmanlike conduct minor, we'll see.
Possibly, because I'm sure Peterson was very upset about the way Martin called him into the penalty box for the last time. Probably said something to the referee, and there he goes again for another minor penalty.
It is an unsportsmanlike conduct minor. 14 minutes into the period, the Eagles have a power play chance for the third time tonight. Don't forget, the Fanatic Fan Contest, sponsored by Delta Airlines, will take place every home playoff game. Dress up, paint your face, make a sign, get wild. During the game, the Eagles will choose the Fanatic Fan of the game, and that person will win a trip for two on Delta Airlines. Here's a play in front. Wordman shoots, and that deflects wide. Here's the play now to the near wing. Eagles on the power play. Holland trying to center one. Here's Dennis Holland with the Eagles trying to tie the game. Hafey now. Forced Salt Lake to the point for Olsen. Across for Holland. Centers one. They just deflected wide. Harkins centers. Hafey is shot. That caroms wide. It's a 3-2 game in favor of Kansas City. Hafey not flying to the ice and a crunching hit. And the Blades fans excited about that. 5:29 to go in the second period. Kansas City leading by a one-goal count, but Salt Lake another minute 20 to go on the power play. Here's 41-goal scorer Sean Hafey at center ice for Kevin Wertman, but tipped and cranked all the way down deep into the Salt Lake zone.
Golden Eagles making a few changes, getting some fresh bodies out there, Mike. They want to get that puck deep and get control of it like they have through the first part of this penalty.
Here's Darryl Olsen able to flip it free as the Eagles punch it in deep. Scrimming for Kansas City, clears but not out. Young holds it in. Here's C.J. Young, 2 goals in the Olympics this year. Works in, holds on, back to the point for Wertman. Shoots, and that just deflects wide. Eagles had a couple of red shirts in front. Here is Salt Lake's Young, hounded, trying to wipe it back in his backhand for Chernomaz. Forslund along the boards for Young. Great pass, Wertman. Hands for Olsen to Wertman, but he can't control it. And Joyce breaks the center, but Wertman stands him up. Salt Lake's Wertman able to break free at center. And the rookie out of AIC College in Springfield, Massachusetts, clears it right back in. Here's Young, steals, shoots it off the side of the goal. 20 seconds to go in the penalty. Here's Chernomaz now. Knocked off the puck by Scrum, and big hits along the boards. They try and work it free. Eagles Young holds it in for Chernomaz. holds on for the moment, but then poke checked and cleared by Kansas City up into the stands along the far side. Eagles desperately trying to tie the game. Again, good work on the power play. Not a lot of good shots on Arthur Irvin.
Not a lot of great shots, Mike, but you can really see the determination now in the Salt Lake Golden Eagles. They're winning the battles in the corners. Right here, you can see Chernomaz working hard up against the boards. Forslund's in there. They're doing a great job of keeping control of that puck. TJ Young will come flying in here to grab it, throw it up towards Chernomaz again, and this is the kind of work that the Golden Eagles have, keep control of that puck and gain some scoring opportunities from it.
Well, one of the fans has a rubber chicken, Randy, with the stripes on it, giving Derek Martin a hard time.
Well, I don't know why. Their team's got 3 power play goals already in tonight's game.
And 6 power play chances on top of that. Now they rule it was dropped unfairly. We'll do it over again with 4:07 to go in the second period. Eagle goals tonight, Clark and Cruz, De Palma, Emmons, and Kravitz in the first period for Kansas City. And look at Kemper Arena, home of an NHL team, and now the Blades in their second year of operation in the IHL. Here's the play now back of the goal. Eagles, Harkins works against Colstead. Former Eagle Rick Lessard, poke check. Eagles in a forecheck. Harkins now in for the forward Cruz, but stop it to play. A Salt Lake player upended as the veteran trainer Brian Patafi rushed into the scene. And it looks like Todd Harkins has been shaken up to the top of the circle.
Another high stick here again, Mike. Harkins has good control of it. Lessard's got a stick wrapped around him. Ooh, wow, he gets it up high and hits Harkins right underneath the helmet. Kansas City Blades are going to go in a shorthanded situation. We'll wait and see. 2-minute minor. Derek Martin's going to call against Rick Lessard. So the Golden Eagles again are going to get another power play opportunity with 3:53 to go in a game. Great chance for them to notch things up.
Brian's two youngsters are at home. His wife Cindy, I know, is watching the broadcast tonight. He says to say hello to the family. And Todd Harkins gets up. Penalty against Rick Lessard for high sticking at 16:07. And the Golden Eagles will go on a power play. 3-2, Blades will come up with a Salt Lake man advantage chance in just a moment. Mike Barak alongside Randy Busick here at Kemper Arena in Kansas City. The Blades with the winningest team, 56 victories this year, the third amount of points in IHL history. Eagles take over on right wing and Forslund able to work free. Lessard the penalty, a high stick at 16:07. Salt Lake looking for their first power play goal. Here's Young, back of the net, hands it for Chernomaz. Eagles trying to tie the game, third by Scrammon outside the blue line. It went off the skate of Chernomaz and ricocheted deep into the Salt Lake zone. 3:08 to go in the period, 3-2 Kansas City. Salt Lake on their fourth power play in this game. And here's the rookie Wertman out of his own end for Salt Lake. He had 46 points this year during the regular season. Winds it into the Blade zone. Irbe winds it to free back of the net, but Salt Lake in a forecheck. Back to the right wing point. Outside the blue line is Wertman, just unable to hold it in.
Well, I'll tell you, everybody's doing a great job, Mike, of grabbing those pucks and throwing it up on the glass and around the boards, making it tough for the Golden Eagles to get in there and get control of it.
Here's Olsen, clears it in. It takes a crazy hop off the backboards and on the mesh. And because Olsen shot it, let's see where they'll wave down the faceoff on that play, because it was shot by a Salt Lake player. Yes, the faceoff, it appears, will be in the Kansas City zone, so a break for Salt Lake.
Big break, but perhaps Derek Martin thought it touched Irbe before it went onto the net, so that's why he's going to whistle it inside the Kansas City zone.
Had it not gone off Irbe, they would have ruled a faceoff outside the blue line. 20-16, shots on goal, Blades. The Eagles were outshot 8-1 to start, have made a game out of it, scoring twice, and have just about worked it free on the shots on goal in an even situation. Here's the play on the left wing side. 37 seconds to go in the penalty, but cleared by the Blades outside the blue line. And the Eagles back after it. Salt Lake 68 power play goals during the regular year. They ranked 6th in the league on power play chances. Here's Olsen now on left wing. Winds it for Wertman. He crosses the red line and bangs it right back deep into the Kansas City zone. Harkins for the Golden Eagles. Hands it for Hafey. Right point for Olsen. On his knees, trying to center one. Blocked away by Colston, and he winds it free on right wing, and the Blades just chip it deep into the Salt Lake zone. 6 seconds to go on the Lessard penalty, and that's just about going to do it. The Eagles break free on right wing. Lessard is back on. Eagles fail to score. They've had their chances. Courtney steals from Olsen. All alone in a goal. shoots Seibold, a fabulous save, and he keeps it 3-2 as Ed Courtney worked it all alone, and Sharples says no.
Wow, what a great job by Warren Scott Sharples, Mike, to come up with a huge, huge save with 1:46 left to go in this period. I'll tell you, Olsen tries to clear it up, he flips it up, but Courtney knocks it out of the air. Sidesteps Olsen, walks right in. Courtney, Sharples, this is it, makes the move. What a great glove save.
Wow, faceoff will come up circle to the left of the net. Bob Francis told me before the game that Scott Sharples, one of his attributes is the fact that he stands up very well, and he stood up there, he didn't go down, and that helped him on that shot.
Well, I'll tell you, when a goalie's standing up, Mike, he covers that much more net, and Sharples, a big guy, he covers a lot of the territory, and it makes it tough for a shooter to find any open areas.
Here's the play in front. Sharples, the save again on Courtney, was robbed on the doorstep. And the Eagles break back 4 men and across the line. Darlin on net. From his center one loose in front. Irby, the save. And he holds on with 3 red shirts in the vicinity. Oh, good scoring chances on both sides.
Well, Sharples doing a spectacular job of keeping that puck out of his net. The Golden Eagles fight back. They come right back down the ice. Kevin Dahl steps in between a defenseman. Just couldn't pull a trigger. Tried to get a shot away, but there's Hafey right in front trying to poke at it. Irby gets a glove on it, but look at the red jerseys around the net.
Eagles had 4 men in Randy on that rush up the ice as Artie Irby with 15 stops this evening, and after sequence right there, a good chance to tie the game.
End-to-end action, Mike, that's what you like to see.
We'll see more of this at the Delta Center Tuesday and Thursday night, 7 p.m., the Eagles and Kansas City. C.J. Young against Ron Andy, Thomas Forslund and Tim Harris as the other forwards, and Sandis Olsalynch able to play it for the Blades. 19 years of age, born in Riga, Latvia. Up the middle for the forward, Quintet. Breaks into the Salt Lake zone against Kevin Dahl. Quintet ridden off the play by Dahl. No penalty, and there shouldn't have been. And the playback of the goal, fans howling all over Derek Martin. Now there's going to be a penalty against Kansas City as they push and shove along the far side. Blades fans felt there should have been a call against the Eagles, but it looks like we'll for sure at least have one minor against Kansas City.
Well, the fans are not going to like this when they see who's going to head off into the penalty box. Here's Kante going down the far side. Dahl gets a stick up high on him, a little bit questionable.
Yeah,
possible penalty right there, but Kante holds on to his stick. He's going to rope down C.J. Young right behind the play there, and he's going to head off into the penalty box for the minor penalty.
And again, retaliatory penalties. We've seen it against Salt Lake this year, and Derek Martin calling it tonight against Kansas City. You can't retaliate, whether it's the Eagles or the Blades.
Boy, that's a tough thing, Mike. Players get very frustrated out there on the ice at times. There you see, not too much questions about that. Just bulldogged them right down to the ice. The Golden Eagles are going to get another man advantage out of this one. A minute 8 to go in a period. Great chance for them to go into that dressing room with things tied up.
5 power play chances for Salt Lake. This will be their 5th. They're 0-4 so far. A minute 8 to go in the period. And I'm sure the Eagles have had time to practice now, Randy, with the power play. It's time to bury one to tie the game.
Well, execution's everything, Mike. Like you said, the Golden Eagles have had good puck possession low inside the Kansas City zone, but they just haven't been able to find the twine.
Afi Chernomaz and Forslund up front. Forslund played on a Canada Cup team for Team Sweden this summer, and it's cleared all the way deep into the Salt Lake zone. Under a minute to go in the period, and Olsen plays the puck back of his net. Here's Darryl Olsen, able to swivel at center ice. Wright's trying for Chernomaz, pokes it free into the Blade zone, whacked right back to center, and Wertman forced Salt Lake on the rolling puck. Left wing for the Eagles, Olsen, he slams it in with 40 seconds to go in the period. Here's Hafey, backs it up behind the goal. It is Chernomaz for Forslund. Nance scrambled to the slot, and Scrimmon leads Olsalynch in his center. 30 seconds to go in the period. Blades are shorthanded. Olsalynch able to hold on. In front of the goal, a chance for the Blades. He scores! Short-handed goal for Kansas City. Dwayne Joyce set up beautifully. And the 19-year-old shows lots of savvy. Sandis Olsalynch to make that pass across.
Boy, Olsalynch just backs up towards his own end, and the Golden Eagles let their guard down. They forget all about Dwayne Joyce, who's flying in towards the net. Look at Olsalynch right here. Fades back, throws it, finds Joyce. Joyce is all in alone. Puts it between Sharple's legs now. That was a huge goal. Just when we thought the Golden Eagles had a great opportunity to tie things up, Kansas City gets a shorthanded tally.
And late in the period, on top of that, it's a killer 4-2 Kansas City in the lead. Sharpless got a piece of it, and I thought maybe he would be able to deflect it out of the goal.
Well, he did get a piece of it, Mike, but just not quite enough. It just found its way through his pads, and that's a huge goal for the Kansas City Blades at this point in time. But, hey, the Golden Eagles are still in the power play and have a lot of time to work with that.
Here's Guy on left wing, ahead for Harkins. 20 seconds to go in the third, and he shoots it in. 18 seconds to go in the period. Eagles Young in a forecheck, centers in the slot, a chance. It'll be the same rebound. He stops Harkins, another chance, and he holds on. Eagles with two golden opportunities in front of Archer Airbay. He stops Todd Harkins in the big chance in front, and now pushing and shoving into the corner, Carter and Dennis Holland, the players involved.
Well, not both teams being very cautious here. There's been a lot of penalties called so far tonight. Neither team wants to jeopardize a penalty or a power play situation, but what a key save here by Archer Airbay. Great pass out to Harkins in a slot all alone. He rips one, Airbay makes a save. Harkins gets the rebound, throws it again at Airbay, and he comes up solid.
Todd Harkins was second in team scoring for Salt Lake this year. 32 goals after a 15-goal campaign in his rookie season, and you're not going to get many better scoring chances than that, but you have to credit Airbay. Stood tall in the nets for the Blades.
Both goalies have come up with huge, huge saves for their teams tonight, Mike, and it's a 4-2 game. Already 6 goals scored in this contest, but had it not been for the heroics of these two goaltenders, the score could be a lot higher.
Faceoff will come outside the blue line. Only 11 seconds to go in the period. Eagles will still have time to start the next stanza. On the power play, a minute 2 left in the penalty, so they'll have about 50 seconds at the start of the next period. Bob Francis unhappy about something, Randy, on the far side, and I think on the positioning of the faceoff, he feels it should be in the Kansas City end.
He's got his arms up in the air saying, why? Why is this faceoff out here? Our defenseman never came in. Their goalie was the one who held onto the puck for the faceoff, and the faceoff should be deep.
Well, we're going to have penalties, too. C.J. Young and John Carter. Young, a roughing penalty. Carter, a slash at 19:49. Eagles work it free. Here's Wertman trying to center one for Holland. In on goal. Shoots! And that deflects wide. He couldn't get a lot of wood on it. It's centered and tipped away. And that's it. The buzzer sounds signaling the end of the second period. Eagles battled back to make it 3-2, but a late shorthanded goal with 29 seconds to go in the period gives Kansas City a 4-2 lead.
Good period by the Golden Eagles, Mike. They worked hard. 4-2, we got 20 more minutes to go. Anything can happen yet.
Well, that's the story here from Kemper Arena. The Eagles outshot 22-19, and we'll come back with our between periods activities in just a moment.
Okay, what do we...
The Salt Lake Golden Eagles in game 2 of their best of 7 playoff series with Kansas City trail at the end of 40 minutes of play by a score of 4-2 here at Kemper Arena. Hi everybody, I'm Mike Barrick alongside Randy Busick. Randy, a late goal by the Blades, a key one to make it a 4-2 game.
Very disheartening, Mike. Your team's on a power play and you give up a shorthanded goal. You have all the momentum going for you and that happens. It hurts. It happened last night and it happens again tonight. Hopefully the Eagles are going to be able to rebound.
Well, the Golden Eagles made a game out of it to make it 3-2, and it was a great play by Paul Cruz to cut the lead.
Just a super individual effort here. He's able to strip the puck off of John Carter's stick, step out in front, swing around, find the far corner against Airbay. What a great goal.
And the Blades came back with a big late goal, only 29 seconds to go in the period to make it a 4-2 game.
Well, great play here by the youngster, Ozalechi. He skates back. He makes a great backhanded pass to find Dwayne Joyce all alone. Joyce finds a little bit of an opening between Sharple's legs. Bang, it's in the net.
Randy, you were a sniper when you donned the uniform of the Salt Lake Golden Eagles. I bet you would love to see passes like that.
Well, anytime you're able to get a pass and the only thing you see in between you and the goaltender is a lot of air, your eyes get very, very big, and it's great. And Dwayne Joyce moved in on Sharples, made no mistake. 4-2 now the lead the Kansas City Blades have, but the Golden Eagles played very, very well that period, Mike, and they're very much in this game.
Bill Clement, who now broadcasts for the Philadelphia Flyers, calls those yay goals when players are all alone in front.
Yay goals. I guess when you put them in the net, you put your hands up and say yay, but it's anytime it's a one-on-one, it's who's ever the best at that moment, the goaltender or the scorer, and Dwayne Joyce threw it in past Sharples.
Randy Busick alongside I'm Mike Barak. Randy, what's the feeling among the players right now? They go to the locker room, I'm sure disheartened by that last goal. What's the feeling in there?
Well, like you said, very disheartening the way that last goal went in, but they're going to come out in the third period with a power play opportunity. Very important for them to get a couple of good quality scoring chances and perhaps get a goal, cut that lead again and go from there. You pretty well have to take it one goal at a time now.
Okay, we're going to take a look at the Ardell Brown two-line pass for the new fans of professional hockey. And it's coming up right here.
The Salt Lake Golden Eagles present the three rules of hockey, the main rules that control the game, as demonstrated by Golden Eagle players Kevin Wertman, Dennis Holland, and Darren Banks, sponsored by Ardell Brown Recreational Vehicles.
Rule number two is a two-line pass. It is illegal for an offensive player to receive a pass crossing more than one line without being touched by a defender. For example, a player cannot receive a pass beyond the blue line if the passing teammate is behind the center ice line. This is a two-line offside. However, a pass from a teammate is legal if the puck crosses only a single line.
People say that rules in pro hockey are a little bit difficult to understand. Hopefully this will help them out a little bit.
Well, the play moves so fast, Mike, sometimes even up here in the booth, we don't know what's going on.
Well, I'm sure that some of the fans would attest to that. The score here, 4-2, Blades in the lead through 40 minutes of play, and we'll come back with our between periods activities here at Kemper Arena in just a moment. Welcome back to Kemper Arena in Kansas City, Missouri. The Salt Lake Golden Eagles trail the Kansas City Blades by 2-4. I'm Mike Barak alongside Randy Busick. And Randy, the Eagles are going to have their work cut out in period three.
Well, they're down a couple, Mike, but they're going to come out with a power play. Good chance for them to get on the board. But Arthur Airbase playing very tough again tonight. And they've got their work cut out for them, no doubt about that. But the goaltenders, period, have been a big story in tonight's game.
We're going to take a look at some of the statistics here tonight at Kemper Arena through 40 minutes of play.
Well, 4-2 the score, shots on net. The Blades holding a slim edge over that, 22-19. The power plays, the Blades again holding a 6-5 edge in that category. But the Golden Eagles have carried the brunt of the power plays over this second period.
Well, the POC computer statistics, but the Golden Eagles had some terrific goaltending. Scott Sharples, although his team down 4-2, made a great save on a play by Courtney all alone.
Courtney walking right in on Sharples, one-on-one. Boy, I'll tell you, this glove hand just comes out of nowhere to stop that puck and keep it out of the net.
And Archer Irbe has been pretty strong in goal as well. He has been terrific between the pipes.
Well, the Golden Eagles have had their chances against Irbe, but he's come up large for the Kansas City team, and he's one of the main reasons why the Golden Eagles have only been able to get two goals on the scoreboard.
Well, we'll see if the Eagles can pot home a couple here in period three. They're down by 2-40. When we come back, Russ Parker, the owner of the Kansas City Blades, will join us. This is Salt Lake Golden Eagles Hockey.